to Amsterdam from Austin, a 9-hour flight done. And I actually have a 5-hour layover right now here in Amsterdam. The flight was good. Passport control was quick. I didn't sleep much, so I'm a little tired, but excited to be inside the European Union. I'm actually gonna go to the gate to see if I can get on standby for an earlier flight, just so I can not be here for 5 hours. There's another flight leaving out to Sweden in an hour, so I'm gonna try and get on that. If not, I will try and head out to town. So we'll see what happens. So my original flight was at 4 o'clock out to Gothenburg, and I went to the gate to ask them if I could get on this earlier flight out at 12:15. And they said yes, they printed me a new boarding pass. So I'm going to Sweden 4 hours early. Expecting to be on a plane this early, but I'll take it. That was a quick 1 hour hop from Amsterdam to Gothenburg, and I am here now in my 17th country. I am in Sweden. I have barely 24 hours here, and I'm heading onwards to Hamburg tomorrow. And in that time, I'm gonna go walk around the city and see what Gothenburg has to offer. I'm here at Gothenburg Central Station. I have no idea where I'm going or what I'm doing, but we'll figure it out as I go along. I'm here in Sweden, it's crazy. Less than an hour into Sweden so far, and I've realized that there are a lot of Swedish people. People speak Swedish here. There is Swedish everywhere on signs. The streets are small. Lots of people ride bikes. It's cold. I love it here so far. I just put myself up at the hostel, and now I'm heading back to town just to spend a few hours outside of my bed. Make the most of my time here in Gothenburg. I gotta sleep early because I am running on like 2 hours of sleep on the plane. So, I am tired. I've made it into town. I actually got on the tram for free. I didn't scan my ticket. I'm heading up to the Skansen Kronen. I hope I said that correctly. I'm at the top of the hill, and here's the city, Gothenburg behind me. Skansen Kronen. I just read a little bit about it. It was built in 1687 on top of this hill to defend the city, and it made Gothenburg the best defended city in the Nordic region, which is pretty cool. Okay, so for my first day-ish in Europe, I am not sure how this whole fika thing works, but I got a coffee. I'm just gonna sit here for a little bit. They have Wi-Fi, and take in the view. Thank you. know if it's just me and I'm just seeing life very much through rose-tinted glasses right now, but I feel like it's so pretty here. I don't know how Sweden does it, that they can even make construction look beautiful. Also, add on top of that the fact that it's 18 degrees right now. It feels like it's fall when we're in the middle of July. I can't imagine living here in Sweden. It's so beautiful. I've made it to Gothenburg City Hall. This plaza looks like it really would have been like this when it was first built, so like in the 1800s, 1700s. That's another thing that I love to do when I'm in a new city, is kind of like imagine myself in that time period when like there are no cars or anything, no modern technology. Gothenburg is a port city, and you can see like the canals coming right through into City Hall. Whenever people travel, they bring a little like mascot along and take pictures of it in like famous locations and stuff. I was never really a fan of that, but this time I decided to bring my little stuffed animal, little Lammy here, with me on this trip. I thought it would be cute to bring it along and take pictures of it in all the major locations that I go to and the friends that I meet. So keep a lookout for more little lamb content. This is little Lammy in front of Gothenburg City Hall. Ow. Good morning vlog. Today is Monday the 25th. It is about 5 a.m. right now. I actually went to bed pretty early last night, but I woke up like 2 or 3 hours ago. I think I'm still pretty jet lagged from coming into Europe. I'm gonna power through today, hopefully make it to a cafe if it doesn't rain. But right now I am editing my vlog, taking in this beautiful hostel. I love the Scandinavian design and excited for a new day. Okay, it's a little cold and gloomy today, but I'll be heading to the central station and figure out what to do from there. Okay, what was that again?
It's like a toffee and then a pastry bottom.
Okay.
And almonds.
Okay, and then the other one?
It's marbulle, and that's like a butter and cardamom.
This morning I spent a little bit too much money on these pastries and this coffee. I didn't have much time in Gothenburg anyway, so I wanted to just sample the coffee culture, the cafe culture here. The barista was really nice. She explained to me a little bit of what these are. I don't know exactly what she said. I was just here yesterday, and I didn't mention this on the vlog, but I love the design of this terminal. It's just a really beautiful terminal, very Scandinavian. Gonna try and wait for a bus to the airport. And I also really love like the central station, the train station, bus terminal vibe, because it seems like everyone's backpacking or going somewhere. I love it. I love the vibe here. I am at the airport waiting for my flight to Hamburg, and that was my 24 hours in Gothenburg. It really did not feel like 24 hours at all. It felt like so much longer. Now I'm continuing my very long journey onward to Austria, and I should be with Kelly and Aurelia in less than 24 hours. It's been so long since I left Austin, but thank you, Sweden. See you again next week.